We're here with highly decorated Lance Corporal Ryan Tomlinson. Lance Corporal Tomlinson, what do you do on a day-to-day basis?
Well, we like to go on separate missions with the Colonel, because you know that Colonel just likes to throw in.
Can you speak up a little bit, please?
Well, it's like being on a spaceship, you know, and I don't quite know what to do with my hands.
Yeah, you can just put your hands down to the side. That should be okay.
Okay. Well, we like to do a lot of missions with the Colonel, and you know how the Colonel likes to sit in the third Humvee back, and it's a great day to be a Marine whenever you're with the Colonel. And
I like to say hi to my mama. Hey, mama, how you doing today? Hey, hey.
Thank you. That's all the time
I'm
we
on
have.
TV. I'm gonna be famous.
Back to you guys in the studio. Hey. Week 9 is a shift in recruit training as the drill instructors and recruits spend less time on the parade deck and more time here at the depot pool.
Being here reminds recruits that the Marine Corps is truly an amphibious fighting force.
Proper swimming technique, rescues, and even swimming while wearing combat equipment are a handful of the skills the recruits are taught.
Another challenge they face is jumping off this 10-foot platform to simulate abandoning a naval vessel.
Luckily, PFC Stephanie Ingersoll didn't put those skills to use as she traveled to Seattle with the Navy.
If you're thinking about taking a cruise, you might imagine traveling to exotic places, relaxing on beautiful beaches, or swimming with aquatic sea life, all on a world-class cruise liner, the Lap of Luxury. For these guys, however, their experience was a little bit different.
I think it was my first night here. I got motion sickness. I hated that.
This rocking is very different.
Yeah, there's no space.
This little wreck, like we have so much space on land.
Recently, more than 120 Marines from Camp Pendleton traveled on the naval vessels USS Bunker Hill and USS Cleveland to be a part of the Seattle Seafair. Most Marines were new to ship life and quickly realized that living aboard a naval vessel is much different than life on an installation. The movement of the giant ship on the ocean and compact living spaces complicates simple tasks. Even walking to the mess hall can be an adventure.
You're either running into somebody, tripping over things, you going through a door, somebody else is coming through, you just gotta get out of people's way.
The ship's crew works hard and is often busy, but our Navy brethren never hesitated to sit down to a meal with the Marines.
But everybody here is like pretty much nice. Like, if you sit in one spot for a little while, there's bound to somebody to like come up to you and start asking you questions or talk to you.
Despite cramped spaces and mazes of ladder wells, the Marines valued the opportunity of traveling with the sailors. Reporting from the guided missile cruiser USS Bunker Hill, I'm Private First Class Stephanie Ingersoll.
We've made it to the obstacle course, which challenges the recruits mentally and physically.
Although they don't have to deal with the sand fleas like we did at Paris Island, homesickness easily sets in with the relentless air traffic from the San Diego International Airport.
Recently, Corporal Ryan Trevino visited a makeshift airport on the sands of Camp Pendleton's Red Beach.
Several AV-8B Harrier jets from Fixed Attack Squadron 311 at a Marine Corps Air Station Yuma ruled the skies over Camp Pendleton's Red Beach July 16th through August 2nd. The Tomcats from VMA 311 focused on many tasks during the training exercise.
The main focus of our exercise here is to set up a forward operating base for our AV-8Bs so we can exercise the short takeoff and vertical landing capability. We're doing hot fuel and hot rearming, so we're reloading and refueling very quickly. And it's all in support of Mojave Viper as well as Third Anglico up in the 29 Palms area.
The Harriers flew in from Yuma each day and landed on Red Beach's runway in order to fill up on fuel and bombs before flying to 29 Palms. This fast-paced environment required the mechanics from DMA 311 to be ready with their tools and their expertise.
The priorities is doing turnaround inspections, which is inspections we do before every flight. We inspect servicing of the aircraft, fuel, hydraulics, oil. We inspect tires, we inspect the blades on the engine.
Once they arrive at Red Beach, we'll get them fuel with the engine running, as well as we'll do a hot reload procedure with the engine running. And they'll take either 500-pound general-purpose bombs or 500-pound laser-guided bombs up to 29 palms. And once they arrive in 29 palms, we'll check in with that forward air controller and provide close air support for those Marines that are preparing and getting ready to go back to OIF.
The roar of the planes could be heard as far away as Oceanside as the pilots circle the runway preparing for a vertical landing, an ability exclusive to the AV-8B Harrier. The ground mechanics of VMA 311 stood ready to take in each Harrier and prepare it for its upcoming close air support mission to 29 Palm. Both pilots and mechanics from the attack squadron consider it a privilege to work with such a unique aircraft.
I think I have the greatest job in the world. I go to work and my office is anywhere from 500 feet above the ground to 30,000 feet. And I've flown all over the world in this airplane and supported Marines in Iraq, as well as in training scenarios and, you know, 29 Palms, Yuma, and Japan. And it is the most rewarding experience.
The Tomcats are scheduled to deploy to Iraq for the third time later this year. Reporting from Camp Pendleton's Red Beach in California, I'm Corporal Ryan Trevino.
I am Jimmy Kimmel. You're watching Marines TV Pendleton for hours and hours and hours every day.
Guess who's doing a PME tomorrow?
All right, I'm glad everybody can make it today. Today's PME is on energy conservation.